So we're back. We're back here at the Curtain Games. Not much to look at the moment. We haven't rolled the mission yet. I'm joined here by Craig Killer Reed. Went out in the quarters. How'd you feel, Craig?
Yeah, all right, mate. Not too bad.
It was an act of sportsmanship that really...
Game, wasn't it? Matt's a nice guy, mate, and he's a...
You let him have the take back and you lost.
He's not feeling very well, bless him, so it was definitely the right thing to do.
He's feeling a lot better now.
To be honest, mate, quite nice to sit here and watch this instead.
It is, and they're building the tiles in front of us. We're literally seeing this come together.
This is live.
This is what people don't get about what goes on behind the scenes of these tournaments.
It's live, isn't it?
So, Alistair Scott and Rob Walker. Let's have a look at the list.
We've got Alistair and Rob in the semis, yeah?
In the semis?
Semi-finals.
2 games away from winning it.
Rob Walker, he's running a scum list. He's got Gideon, a couple of regular HKs. Beast Tamer, Temporary Alliance, he's got one Bantha, he's got Unshakable, Tusken Raider, and C-3PO.
It's a bit familiar to yours?
Yeah, it's another take on the Beast Tamer list.
Yep.
I think probably
how do you see
a
the
slightly
Banthas?
More powerful early game.
Early game, so you're going to storm forward the Banthas, kick it out the way.
Yeah, I'd say.
It's like we're fighting in Tatooine.
I always find like Beast Tamer and one Bantha seems like a lot of points in the one model there really.
And he's running the tax, the focus tax as we call it.
Yeah, I think the focus tax is a standard thing in the game at the moment, isn't it? Especially for scum, really pushes the HKs over the edge.
So this is Alistair Scott's list while we're looking now.
Do you usually go through command decks as well?
I wouldn't.
Okay, so we're on the Cantina map and we are playing Battlefield Engineering. So that's just been rolled up by the tournament organiser.
We're not going to go through the command cards, just in case somehow they get a message to them.
Okay, mate.
But we can speak hypothetically. What would you have in your command deck if you were running that list?
Tim, I've got the flu, mate.
He can't think. He doesn't have the cognitive capacity.
Should we just do Alistair Scott's list? This seems to have been a strong performer all day.
Assign you the right person. I was assigned backwards last time. All my friends were like, "Oh, I'll serve with the last." I was like, "Come on, come on."
So Alistair there complaining about the organisation, which is completely legit, Alistair. It is bad. It's poor at best. So Alistair's list is Agent Blaze. It's obviously a new model released with the Bespin set. Same time as Bespin.
Running the Wing Guard.
It's got a couple of units of Elite Stormtroopers and a unit of Elite Wing Guard, which, we haven't playtested too much, but...
I had the Ugnaught today, though, which I...
Zillow Technique, which is... really been seen today here in force, and it does definitely seems to be a good idea. And then obviously temporary allies to make the list legal.
It always helps, doesn't it?
It always helps. Shouldn't have got this far otherwise.
Who would you pick? Who's your pick?
Okay, if I were to pick one early on, I would probably. I'll say the Imperials.
The Imperials. So go Alistair.
He's been a strong performer all day.
Yep.
He's had no shaky wins. He's won well every game. Actually, the guy that agreed to an intentional draw with me in fifth round before the cut. I think his list consistently puts out enough damage to drop that bound for quickly. I know from playing two HKs as well that facing off against 6 Stormtroopers with Zillow Technique, undoubtedly reinforcements is going to be tricky. I'll put my money there.
Go on, talk us through the mission.
The Battlefield Engineering, played, like I say, on the Cantina map. It's the scenario at the moment that can give you the most VPs for playing towards winning on the scenario. 10 VPs is huge. There's potential to score 20 VPs out on the board. There's a couple of plays here which most people tend to go that I've seen. You either go and try and get a couple of components and take 10 VPs, or you just go and grab one token and accept your opponent's going to get 10 VPs. If I was the scum player, Tim, I would probably just take the one token.
Okay.
And deny my opponent those 10 points, accept that he's going to get 10, and then play it that way. But it'll be interesting to see what the guys do.
So, Rob and Alistair, if you let us know when you've scored your points.
Yeah.
Okay, and Oakley will work with you.
So what about you? Well,
I'm gonna go with Alistair, the man I gave a lift in this morning. He talked me through what he was going to. He saw the day. I think he was quietly confident.
Lovely guy. They've both been strong performers.
Rob Walker again. You can't go look past Rob. Came in with a bye. one of the two buys today.
Yeah. Which means he deserves the buy. So,
he's gone the distance again.
Can we do me a loaner for the next? Does anybody have a spare wing guard and spare brains?
No, say no.
Disqualified. It's just Robbie really sporty in there.
we're just looking for some missing models.
So I think we're listening for some looking for some missing command cards at the moment, which is why there's a delay in starting. Let's see how this goes. Just bear with us. Alistair, you might be trying to find some cards, mate.
I'll be all right as long as my command deck isn't
They're readying the lawyers. Apologise for Craig's language, been a long day. And he lost in the quarters. And he's poorly. He's morally poorly, yeah. He's quite you don't get a nickname like Killer Reed by being nice. No, we're ready to go. Are you ready, Alistair?
We are ready to go.
Both players just want to lean in camera and give it a little wave. Hey, we saw them. Alistair is on the right, Rob on the left. Well, we need that for the start. You can't. That's got to be up. Press start and it's gone. And we close it then. Should we have another word from our sponsors? Rob Angel, where is he?
Firestorm Games, our sponsors.
No, I've got a point. Firestorm Games, who ran a regional? Smaller than this one. This is the largest in the country. In the world.
Nah, joking aside, word to our sponsors, Amarat Bar, Snack Bar.
He's been at him.
Lukewarm eggs all day long.
that's the pun, lukewarm eggs.
Right, so.
Chewy toffee. Well, Sangnorf, they've done well. You know, if they want to find people at their regional.
No, Firestorm, good.
Okay, very good.
Used to get a lot of stuff at Halls and War Machine games and stuff.
Used to, being it.
Play Halls and War Machine.
No, well, they're a lot bigger operation than us. They're good guys.
Yeah, yeah. Rob West, lovely guy. Top.
Mate. Shout out there from Craig Reed.
Certainly a better human being than Rob Angel.
that's tournament judge Rob Angel. He's waving his arms and now making a rude gesture. Okay, no, there we go. Dodge. Right, we're getting ready.
As you should know, this list is untested against the Bantha.
His list is untested against the Bantha. Does that change it for you?
Yeah, Alistair, they're saying.
Does that change it?
No, it doesn't change it for me, I don't think, Tim. I know from being a scum player. Similar list for HKs, a couple of different beasts running around the league next to myself. I worry about the Stormtrooper list, if I'm honest. And I think Agent Blaze is a new element to the game.
Okay.
Powerful. Yeah, no. It's going to be interesting.
It's going to be interesting.
Semi-final.
Okay, so you're looking at both. We see the setup there of the scum on the left. What? How do you see it going? Is he chanting up?
I do see the Imperialist winning out. I watched the tail end of Rob's last game against Dave Perks, playing with Imperialist. Not quite the same as this Admiral Guard, and Elite Pro Droid, and a few other things. And that was awfully close. He doesn't put out damage like this Stormtrooper list does. So, it will be interesting. I mean, Rob's a great player, don't get me wrong.
You're making your choice. I'm still on the fence.
Of course you are. Always on the fence.
Can't get off the fence, but if I had to bet...
Until it breaks.
Okay, I'm going to go with the scum, the Bantha.
Interestingly, the scum player there, Rob, is deployed. He's taking the same deployment as I would.
Yep, okay.
Yeah.
That's the tweaking.
With no devious scheme, which I consider quite cutsy for a scum player.
Okay, we'll get ready to start.
Calling the start of the round now. Nice handshake from the guys.
There we go, we're off.
And we're off.
So that goes to 3PO, the human focus machine. I sound so cynical when I talk about 3PO now.
decides to.
Quite handily, we can see the scores here thanks to this wonderful app.
Yeah, it's great.
It's going to be a magic life counter, but
it is good.
He's complaining.
So it looks like Alistair is just obviously the key to do here really is make you play for your tokens. This will tell us.
Going for the long shot.
So it's very, very long shot.
Use one of those circles to interrogate your hand.
Yeah, they do need to,
Just going to ask the guys to roll the dice pot just so you guys at home can see what's happening here.
Oh, shit.
Sticklers for the rules. Can't really see it.
Okay, so we've asked the players to roll on the dice pot for everyone at home's benefit, and I've just realised for the first time you can't actually see what's in the dice pot.
You can work out when there's X's.
There's a couple of yellow dice and there's a green one.
Yep. That's enough.
Yes.
I think he's criticising his eyesight.
Okay, so there's three.
Fine cup of tea there from Admiral Akbar snack bar. Up at the top.
Lukewarm eggs.
Colour of He-Man's skin.
It is.
You always know the colour of a good cup of tea.
It is. So that was Agent Blaze then, by the way.
Blaze going for the long shot, going out in the blaze of glory potentially.
He did have a little cheeky up there.
Because the Banther's got so much health, you've got to start putting stuff on it early doors, otherwise it will go straight through.
Okay. I would say what we've just seen there is Gideon moving a tactical manoeuvre in the Banther and pushing a couple of models further up the table.
Somewhere there's our tournament judge, probably in the car of the hosepipe. You understand about colour commentary? It's about the colour more than the commentary.
Brilliant. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two,
come the hard guns.
Well done.
See?
Yeah, you on it.
Even a stop clock is right twice a day.
Strong player, you'll grab them. Force a counter now, and otherwise he's going to take those two tokens. Could be an easy 10 VPs.
Get him on the board early. Mission's forcing him to be early and aggressive.
He's gone off to a terminal with the Tusken, which is cool. That's at the moment appear to be letting those two tokens go. I'd say the one on the entrance to the cantina from the moisture farm. That's easily contestable. Okay, so it's a good play. He's gone and contested there, which is nice. If they end up in a 1-1, the high gun.
See, Alice is hedging his bets, though. He can go through the channel. He's got a push. Which way would you take your majority of forces there, Greg? South or north?
Hard to say.
Is he going to have to deal with the bat for early, or is he going to risk it?
Just trying to work out what model that is, Tim.
Well, this is. Blaze.
No, that's not Blaze, boys. That was Blaze.
That's the Wingard.
He's a Wingard.
Yeah.
The Wingard moving up, yeah.
Wingard, of course, with their ability to force strain, using the guard.
I'd say he's probably taking time, carefully placing so he doesn't get a Banff land on top of more models than he wants it to. He's working out at the moment. He's working out a beast tamer and where the Banff can get to. Really does dictate the pace early on. My favourite thing to do is to accept to lose a bit of ground to it, bring it on to you, try and draw it away from the rest of its force.
Well, there's only one, he can only go one way, can't he? So.
Well, it's more to do with if you can isolate it, its speed is its advantage, but also its weakness.
Okay.
So if you can isolate it and take it out without losing too much on the scenario. Cup of tea going down there, Tim.
Yep. How's the cup of tea, Alistair?
Going down really well.
There we go.
I will credit my success to this cup of tea.
This is really a stream for tea drinking, featuring additional assault.
I mean, the good thing about doing this together, Tim, is you add so much.
Oh. I'll wait for the drama to come out.
Yeah. Controversy.
Controversy.
So yeah, it'll be interesting. So obviously he's holding the Banff off, mate. It's quite often the Banff is one of the last things to go on a first turn, I'm sure you know.
See that, one of the clear dice in the dice tray, he's won.
We'll know, genuinely will know a lot more at the end of this first turn.
That's always the way, really.
Yeah.
Yeah. Surge blocker and a pip of damage. And there he goes. One hard gun. Wasted?
No. No, I wouldn't say so.
Where are the terminals on this map? One in the cantina and one at the opposite, yeah.
One
the
bottom corner by the moisture farm there. Yeah. Yeah. The centre tile there.
2, 3, 4. Shoot your HK.
Yeah, so
you've
drawn the HK.
1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm. 5 damage to take it.
One good. Yes.
Taking a bit of damage actually. It's only 3 to kill that.
Oh, 3 to kill it. There we go, thank you, Alistair.
So only 3 left on that HK, yeah. Give me a lot of piece exchange going on this game, I think.
Blue.
The tip of the tap. The Stormtrooper player can afford to do this though. The scum player can't.
No. It's gone.
Painful.
Oh, no, no, that's 3 damage minus your 2. Sorry.
Oh, okay, so it's back on the
it's
table.
Back
actually,
on.
So he's only got 2 health left, so he done 1 damage to it. Just looking at that map, and I don't think with a speed of 4.
Yeah,
so that will be the last shot from that Stormtrooper squad, because at 4 speed, they just can't get another shot.
On double moves.
Mm-hmm. Now, at the end of my turn, I'm going to play change of plans.
Okay, nice.
I'll get rid of these white Stormtroopers to run those reds.
There
excellent,
we go.
Excellent. So yeah, so obviously played with the intention of that card in mind. Some Panthers still to go as well.
So spreading the Stormtroopers out there, intentional to reduce the impact of the battle.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. So 10 minutes, ticking up to the 10 minute mark in. Both players look to be feeling the pressure. Wide eyed. The shakes. He's gone back for that cup of tea. And it's down.
That's my tell. That's what I do right in front of the roll of blank.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Upsets the HK.
I've got a range 5 on that guy. No line of sight.
Mm. Oh, you sure do.
Yeah.
He's commentating for us, so we don't have to.
Which way?
He's going to go for, so hit you.
Okay, some dice in the pot again.
Dice in the pot, but we
no
see what happens. We
blue,
see him find out.
Certainly a focus HK.
Two blocks.
Make him reroll. Two blocks. Is he forcing a reroll?
Blue.
Would you force it?
Do you want to reroll?
He's rerolling one of these.
I'll see what I get first.
Oh, you have to choose both at once.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay. What was this one? That was that.
Okay, so he might be taking that reroll. Okay, so he's rerolling the blue, and that's got something on it.
That's got a hit,
double,
surge,
double
and a 3.
Oh, you did one.
It's
just
double damage in a range.
So just, okay, fine.
And he's forcing a reroll on the defensive dice, probably looking for a 1 or a circle.
Yeah,
that's
that
better, no blocks there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Looks like he's one shotted a Stormtrooper.
You need to tell me exactly what you're doing. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
That will be
4 damage.
Plus 1.
Yep. 5 damage.
So that's 5.
Yep.
It's definitely a Stormtrooper
right
downside.
I can keep
Zilla
him alive with
Zillow. But he has got Zillow technique, so he can obviously tag on.
And also
on
minus 2 pierce.
Alright, okay.
Which is once per turn.
Alright, that one will be
Yes. Okay, so just discussing some interactions with
Zillow Tendon.
Fierce implications and the damage saving.
Five damage.
And a weaken.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pierce and a weaken.
Okay. Respond to that command deck.
I'll drop intelligence deep to keep him alive. Weakened, but with one health left.
Well, let's go to the chat room, which no doubt will be a hive.
Can we look in the chat room, come on? Is there a chat room?
There is a chat room.
It's in the chat room.
Not many people, most of them streamers watching from here. But of course, this will end up on YouTube forever, Craig, so. Think on.
Tim blows goat.
That was never substantiated.
Well, not really. First one could have done.
I'll put a focus on.
Put a pirate emoji in the chat room.
Right, I'll go with my reds.
Yeah.
We'll attack the HK at once.
Looks like that HK is going to drop now, Tim.
Here we go.
Interestingly, spacing of the HKs isn't really optimal. Spacing of these storm troops isn't really optimal in the squad training rerolls. So,
no.
Quite interesting that.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know, mate. I don't know. I mean, I think
it's the end of a long day.
Probably because they only had two health, and he'd do.
Okay.
With what he added, probably be able to drop him anyway.
Are we seeing some scores?
It's kind of wasted ability.
One, two, three.
But
well, he's still early, aren't we?
But he's pulled right back there as well, so he's used all four moves to get out.
We've still yet to see the Panther go.
One, two.
Yep.
Grenadier.
Grenadier, Tim.
Grenadier.
Beautiful command car.
Here comes the red dice.
Two damage. Double damage by the looks of it.
Say hi to our seven viewers. Mm-hmm. That logged in anyway.
Eight if you include Rich Parks, who stood to the side watching the game live.
Pitch side.
He's a lousy runner.
He's waving
today.
But he ain't on camera.
He hasn't done great today, bless him.
Do you think he ever recovered from...
I don't think he ever recovered from the sex change, to be honest, Tim.
I was going to say, from your beating of him.
He used to be a great man.
Now he's a wee man. Cut down to size. Here comes the Panther.
Well, seriously, it's still quite a few people stayed, haven't they?
Here's
really?
The Panther. Oh yeah, most of them because they're giving lifts back to people who are still playing.
Yeah.
How
yeah.
cross would you be?
Okay, yeah. So Panther's right in there. It's always changed denied flank really with the Panther, isn't he? He's really
look at
flank.
That movement though.
Probably hoping to clear that room out.
Hard gun in the line. The Tuscans and the Banff have taken the bar.
Yep. So Highlight Gun's going to give up 4 points and no one's scored anything yet.
Pretty much a normal occasion on Tatooine, isn't it? You know, Banff is in the bar.
Banff in the bar.
Banff in the bar.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And that up.
Banff has seemed to visit bars more than anything else these days, doesn't
it? It used to be more the kind of the club. Clubbing used to be in. Clubbing with a lead pipe. But,
I expect you've picked up worse at 10 to 2 in the morning in a bar, Tim, haven't you, than a Banff?
Picked up my glass before chucking it. Someone, as we were talking about bar fights earlier, your game much like a bar fight.
Was like a bar fight. It was
bar fight,
game.
And
really
yet you brought
really
sportsmanship to
yeah,
a bar fight,
did,
and you
to
lost.
To be fair, now Matt's he's a lovely lad, basically, and he's a
let the Wookiee win. That's what we were all saying.
Let the Wookiee win, man.
Let the
Wookiee
win.
No, genuinely, he's a good player. He's
and
a
he
good
deserved
player,
it.
Mate. The intent was there to use that card.
Yep,
and,
that's fair enough.
Yeah.
Play to
it
intent.
It would have been hollow to do anything without it. It's better to play someone at their optimum, isn't it? Really.
I don't disagree.
So you going to nationals then?
I don't think I will be, but of course our judge, player judge today, James Fox.
Our player judge,
running
James
it.
Fox. Yeah, James Fox will be running nationals.
King of Nationals. Of course, I must say that your views, Craig, do not represent those of Curtin Games.
Or James Fox.
Or James Fox.
James Fox.
Before we get in there with any other
on PC
comments.
Yeah. They don't even represent me, you're quite right, mate. So yeah, Bamford in the bar.
Bamford
still
in the
a Bamford in the bar. There's a Bamford in the bar. I don't think anyone's taken a drink yet either, have they?
No one's even mentioned they don't like his face.
It's well pointed out by one of the spectators.
Of course, it was drinks and deals that was beat. Matt Watson beat me out earlier, 35
did
to
he?
40.
Interesting.
Took my eye off the ball.
Pundit side of things, mate.
Well, for me, that was my moment I had to start my pundit
career. So here come the Wingard. Which are. I'm not sure what I think of Wingard yet, Tim, in all honesty.
He was telling me this morning of his plan to use him alongside the Stormtroopers, force the strain. I think I can tell you one thing about them, they're 6 points, the basic. And of course they have the ability, if you shoot something they're next to that isn't a guardian, you can take one strain and force one strain on your opponent.
Something like that, yeah.
That's true, yeah, that's the rule. I nearly took them.
We'll get some cards, we can discuss some of these.
I think the elites are 9 points, actually. Six and nine. I do. I just sit on my knowledge.
Because it's in your ass.
Oh, touche. Got to be somewhere. Why do you think it's so big?
Little honorary mention here to Chris Oakley.
Scorekeeper?
Christopher Oakley, scorekeeper. Sat here silently next to us with a keyboard.
Well, it's because there's been no score yet. Guys, you not scored yet?
No,
we
haven't scored any points yet.
Nope. No. That's all right. You're not disappointing us. You're just disappointing the millions of people watching us. That's that cough was your most cutting comment. Yeah, I'd say, Greg. Right to the heart of the matter.
Last one.
Yeah. So I think some points have just been scored there. We'll just work out what from.
As we say that, of course, there's a
what
score.
Saying, what's been killed? Is it unit HK's gone down? So it's 8 points, is it, to Alistair?
One, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, so yeah, Alistair's just taken out unit HK's. Seven. Yeah.
1, 2, 3. It still kind of feels like we're a bit in the feeling up process. 7. Feeling out or not feeling out, Craig.
I heard what I wanted to hear. Okay. Thank you, Dave. So we've just got the
Wingard card. Oh, are they 9 points, as I said?
You said six.
I said six for the basic,
all
nine
right,
for the elites.
All right. So yeah, so the elite Wingard. So there you go, Tim. I'll have a readout and just
tell
what the card does.
Keep
what
the peace. Surge plus 2 damage.
Yeah.
Or recover 2 for your Wingard.
Yeah.
Very good, because their ability. Keep the peace.
And then why don't we go through, just before that, just go through health and
five,
speed.
Five
and
health. 4 speed.
Yeah.
One black dice
defense. Yeah, it's what you'd expect.
Blue-green going forwards.
Okay, yeah, good.
We've got keep the peace. When a hostile figure declares an attack targeting a space adjacent to you, if that space does not contain a friendly guardian, you may suffer one strain. If you do, the attacker suffers one strain. Limit one keep the peace ability used per attack.
Okay, just before we respond on the card there, if anyone was wondering what that was, it was a chocolate Death Star in the dice rolling pot.
Oh, was it? I missed that.
Yeah,
I wonder if it looked like one of those on the stream or if it looked like someone else. Go on, take it away. I mean, literally, take it away.
I mean, I don't know at the moment, mate. I don't know with him. I haven't really.
Ah, so the HK's have gone for 8 points, is that right?
There's one HK's down, so one to go.
Recover two.
No, he's got one to go, it's not gone yet. There's still one on the board.
One unit. One full card off the table.
Thank you, sorry. Okay.
Yeah, sorry, just clarifying there.
Because
one unit
HK's
thing, is down and one unit is.
We have the right score. I trust you, sorry. You've done it.
Recover two.
Yeah. Really, we're good, because when you're straining yourself, you want to recover.
A trooper unit, which at that point is cost of 9, and then 3 are reinforceable.
They are reinforceable.
Surge plus 2 damage is excellent. It is excellent. Especially when rolling a blue and a green. So,
that's at the elite.
I just don't know. I'd rather have 3 units of elite store troopers.
They don't synergize very well with Wingard.
I'm
not playing.
So,
there we go.
Yeah.
He said to me this morning, Alistair said to me, he said they're a bit of a gamble. But what do you do?
All right, so if you start beep, 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 you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, if you're nasty.
It's my presence is making him feel better.
Let's go with 1, 2, 3.
I said we wanted a camera under the table to see what was going on. All the dodgy dealings that go on. How's he going to deal with the bouncer, Craig? That's what we want to know. As the kids say, it's right up in his grill.
He kind of owns the cantina at the moment, yeah. I'd say Rob looking like he owns the cantina. Alistair can, obviously, the unit of stormtroopers that he used to exhaust an activation to flip the others to get the advantage on the HKs in the last round, they could move back round. From where they're still in the problems, and they could move back round and go into the cantina the other way. But the Banffers in striking distance up there as well. If I was a better man, I'd say Rob's probably going to own that cantina.
Okay.
And try and get a few interacts and a few points.
Just doesn't seem he's got enough over there to push the Banffer back. Hey, turn. It's a combination. As you can see, the viewers can see this for themselves, Craig. If they're firestorm games, we're more like firebomb games, aren't we? Iron Haven? I want to know about Iron Haven. Rob, you better get that lawyer on her. Lawyer and retainer. As you can see, going back to the game, Craig Reed.
Yeah, I'm back with you, Tim.
It's 10-8. He's combined two components in the cantina, as you predicted. And I will say to everyone mocking him, Craig did predict that. Posterity.
I predicted it right at the point.
As I said.
One of each of his figures had a token under it.
Yeah.
And they were within a move and an interact range. So I won't take a huge amount of credit.
The stopped clock is right twice a day, Craig. So.
It is. That is correct, mate. And if James Fox, National Tournament Organiser, doesn't button it, I'll be another word from our sponsors. And he's walking away, ladies and gentlemen.
That's accidents for you, right?
That's right, mate. Yeah.
We organise accidents for you. I'm still trying to get a word from our judge. Judge! He's silent. Did someone cut his tongue out?
Anyway.
Back to the game.
Be interesting to see where Banffer goes next turn.
Shutting down the corridor into those stormtroopers. And certain death.
He's taking this. He's got massive move. The two red squares in the Imperial deployment zone don't bother him at all.
So with Beast Tamer, how far can he move?
I think it's 15 inches off the top of him. I haven't played him out, but yeah, 15 squares. Nearly an inch. Who's counting?
He's counting.
Yeah, no, to
what's
be
the square between friends?
Oh, 15. Beast Tamer, then a move.
Is that Gideon pushing in?
What we did, I'm just going to ask for Chris how much damage that Banffer is.
Okay,
Chris, could you just tell us how damaged that Banffer is, please, mate? Has the Banffer got any damage on it? Chris just going to check the damage on the Banffer. One thing we haven't thrashed out with this streaming is, well, as I'm sure you can tell, the commentary. And,
I'm only here because I lost
how
my
we
games.
We can really track damage in a live environment. We can add it to YouTube, but.
Yep, 3 damage.
It's about 4. Can you not count?
I just shout and ask him.
So we're being told at the moment that the Banffer's on about 4, and I do quite
got a score change there. Score, Rob's got up to.
So yeah, we have just had a score change. We'll just find out what's happened there.
Rob, how much damage has the Banffer taken? Please.
Right, okay.
One.
So,
no, sorry.
Alistair's just lost the higher guns as well, which is where the additional 4 points came from.
8. The Banffer's taken 8.
The Banffer's taken 8, which is about 4.
If you times it by 2.
About 4.
Yeah. Thanks, Rob. Sorry to interrupt.
Cheers, Chris.
So the game's starting to get away from Alistair. Hard guns are gone, but they always go. Even X-Men can't save them.
Well, this is going to be really informative, my next comment. They kind of do and they don't.
Get off the fence.
I've had two games today where the hired guns were fantastic. I think if you can present enough threats to your opponent and get the hired guns left behind, they can do some really, really strong things.
Yep, and they've got, you know, that ability to shoot when they're dead, so even when they are getting killed.
It is good.
A word from our real sponsors there popping up.
Google.
It started filling out lawyers.
So as we said, so here we go. Look, so he's
Guess that shit that Panther, isn't he?
He's a massive range shot from Stormtrooper. I haven't seen him play like this.
Has he never seen the films?
He's got. I'm sure
they don't hit from range.
One, two, three, four. They don't hit at all, do they?
Anyone that's set to start.
I mean, you know, fair play to him. I mean, I've never seen a Stormtrooper play this. I'm sure some reviewers at home have. Right,
force and reroll. It was 7 range. No, just short.
Yeah. But he was using that Stormtrooper reroll there, which is obviously
advantageous.
A good thing to do. No need to. You say that it looks like the game's getting away from Alistair. What you've got to remember as well is he can play quite aggressively at the moment. He hasn't used any reinforcement cards yet.
No? He's got that for sleeve. When would you use the reinforcement cards? Traditionally, it's in
when
and played early.
When a Stormtrooper dies.
Yeah. Oh, he's got one for sleeve. He's not lost any.
No, he may not have them in his hands.
Lost one here, hasn't he? Commander.
Oh, there is. Okay, so the other semi-finals ended. Matt Watson, the guy I lost my quarter-final game to, good player, local player down here in Exeter in Devon. Has just won.
Has he won?
He's won in 38 minutes, so well done to Matt Watson.
Big news.
And look forward to watching Matt in the final and not being sat opposite him on the table too.
No, oh well, me too. Beat me 35-40 early on this very map.
Pretty,
I was so close.
Really tough experience playing Matt. I mean, Matt's a good player of any game system he plays. So
And he's stayed the distance today.
And to be honest, watching Matt against either of these two lists, I would say the one that Matt would least like to play would be the Stormtrooper list. He's definitely more at home.
I disagree, and I'll tell you why.
I'm glad you'll tell me.
The Trandos, how are they going to deal with the Matt? He's going to have to get close. He's going to be in their grill. Trying to get the strain, trying to force the extra damage to the scatter guns.
And they get a +1 damage. Trandos have got.
But they've got to be close to get it.
They've got 6 health.
6 health, they're fragile.
So really, the best
thing.
A Banfor on its best day with the right activation cards and stuff might chew through 2 to 4 Trandos in a turn.
So when you've only got 8, that's only 2 turns, and then Bosk's just sat there twiddling his lizard tail.
Yeah.
Going to be interesting.
No, certainly interesting. But again, it comes down to that art with Banfor of not letting it get far away from the rest of your force. It ends up unsupported, isolated, and camping.
And this is what Rob's doing well here. He's got the Banfor in the bar while supported by Tuscans.
That's fantastic. I mean, this ranged game, those Stormtroopers at best are tickling that Banfor. I'm just going to look through Rob's list, and I'm going to do it quite quietly because I'm going to see if... there's a card.
Good win for Matt, Chris.
There's a card that isn't on his list here. Survive.
Brutality win, they're saying over there.
Which is fantastic with a.
Just lost 2 Trandos and Boss.
Stormtrooper. Against. When he's fighting against Banfor with that +1 block and +1 central. Sorry, Tim, I'm talking quietly because I don't want the guys to hear about these command cards.
I talked over you a little bit though.
Yeah, no, that's a cool win.
Matt just lost 2 Trandos and Boss.
So Matt Watson won with
just
Bosk and 2 Trandos.
Against the Bosk list, wasn't it?
Two from the same group, Chris, you can tell. It was okay, so a group of Trandos and Bosk. So
not bad.
Only gave up, what,
15 points? 16, I think.
Eight and seven?
8 and 7, sorry.
Yeah, it's 15, yeah.
Under duress, of course. You can't that.
Okay, so a lot of spread around damage then. Yeah.
Bit of a mirror match, that one.
Improvements for the next stream then. Need a better camera for that dice pot, don't we?
We actually have a better camera that Amazon failed to get us on time despite us getting Prime.
And a better dice rolling box, as I
understand. And a better dice rolling box. So we've been let down by Amazon Prime
twice.
So
is James going to speak to
what's the head of Amazon called?
Stevium concerning streaming at Nationals, or is it something he's been allowed to do? Do we know?
I don't know anything on that, and I wouldn't want to comment. I'll be political on that one.
Yeah, that's what I'm playing. So, how are you going to remove this gun? Damage. Yeah, And maybe we'll try and get a word from the teams on that.
Well, maybe not best football on the spot. Look for details on the streaming on the website.
We can ask them if you'd like to do it.
Off the stream. I think it would be, I think obviously as you're seeing from our attempts here, it's in its infancy. We're giving it a go. We're going to try it more out of our shop, Curtain Games.
I think it would be very interesting. It would actually be very interesting to get some feedback from viewers.
Yep. If you've got any feedback, please send it, even if it's just slating me and Craig.
To Firestorm Games.
No. players with GoPros are what I want to see. Players I view.
Yeah.
Pretty sure Rob's got some in his private collection.
Yeah.
The only man he's managed to find 4 video cameras to film other games today.
Yeah, which no one's seen.
No one's ever seen. And we
will see. Or will want to see.
Back to the game, though. Okay, the Bamford's on the move.
Okay, see, he's quite telling now, isn't it? Because the Bamford's brought himself back into the mix and not taking the long way around.
Is that Wingard gone?
Yes, it was a Wingard. Then I just asked Chris, was that a Wingard? Yeah, so just dropped a Wingard.
See him on the card there.
And a bit of damage shot to another Stormtrooper there as well.
So at the end of the phase, a reset. Okay. Any change in points, chaps?
No, that's contested.
Yes. So still 14-8. Tight game.
So we approach the halfway phase.
End of action.
Yeah, and a couple of minutes off halfway phase, like you say, mate. Yep.
Initiative goes back over. It's now with Rob. Does he go for the bouncer straight away?
I'd say it's going to be a strong play with a bouncer here now, because he's blocking either side for everything else.
Stormtrooper's dead.
Yeah, we only have one health left. So
if he's got that reinforcements card, we're going to see it soon, I'd imagine.
Well, you'd see it at the start of the turn, Tim.
Oh,
so
he doesn't have it.
Yeah,
by,
Now, obviously, the strong actually here would be to kill the last of the red squad to stop them coming back on the table. Interesting, you can only play one reinforcement. You can only play one card at the same time.
That's
under attack, so at the beginning of the next turn, he's got it. You can only play one reinforcement card. There's only one Stormtrooper will come back.
Here comes the defense. It's in a good search.
Logical move right now. Logical move right now would be, if it was me, I would try and overextend.
Okay.
Stormtrooper to stop them return to the port.
Is that risk for the overall strategy of the battle for the overextension?
I'll drop to the limit.
It's vulnerable anyway.
Yep.
Anything around it can hit it.
He's taking considerable damage now.
Do we know how much damage the Bamford's taken yet?
Oh, it's after it's been ready. So actually, this is the end of round effects. So
yeah, so that's not been ready.
It has been. Are you ready for it? So we'll be out this round. Okay, so he's
I would ask for the
debate. Two damage.
Debating something.
Yep.
That's two on the Wingard. On Blaze, sorry. Blaze or Wingard?
No, right, it's Wingard. Blaze is back behind the two Stormtroopers. Yeah, Blaze is back behind the two Stormtroopers there. You can tell Blaze because he's got...
He's holding his gun up.
As a questionable pose, shall we say. Yeah.
Matt, you're going to the final. How do you feel? Now speak up. Tired, but very excited.
Well done, Mr. Watson.
One game from glory. Some people dream of this. Some people train for this, but you've done it. He was medicated for your many ailments, thanks to the NHS.
Okay, start of the next round.
Yep.
Nothing activated.
Bamford activated. No, he's called it Jungle and Terror.
So the way the Stormtrooper died then was actually the end of a round with a Jund and Terror card being played. We're just at the start of the next round now. I'm just going to find out who has initiative. Just ask Chris. Chris, who's got initiative, please?
Rob. I can see the card. The coin. Follow the coin at the top, above the board.
Top tip from top tip from Tim, the power bland.
That's what they call me. Power's out bland.
Powers out. Lights out.
Quiet.
As we said, as we predicted. Move from the play from the Bamford early.
Is he going to go for that trooper?
Very quiet in the room.
Yeah, don't want to speak and wreck it. He's shunting into the Wingard. As only a Bamford can.
Okay.
He now owns that room.
Do it. It's fine, he's going to trample now, so this will be one red dice.
I've seen the one that rolled before. Can happen.
He's calling the one.
Two damage.
And the one we guard there in trouble.
Two cycler off the top of the band for that.
Yep.
I'm doing one, two, three, piss two.
Three and a piss two. Need mitigates the surge.
Well, obviously with a tactical cycler, surge effects don't apply. I know you know that.
But that's enough to take the wing guard up.
Wing guard down, so big
lead now opening up for Rob.
Point swing for Rob there. So
is that fine?
By swing, what I mean. sadly, not at the moment, mate. It's
30 minutes.
30 minutes left. 30 minutes and 5 seconds.
Now's the time to start taking those bathroom breaks.
I'm going to use the one at the hotel.
Shot, range 3. With focus and reroll.
It's been aggressive. It's covered the board.
He's had a few drinks in the bar now.
Yep. Put that in slow-mo. Slow-mo that bouncer.
He's out with the moisture farm now.
Okay, so that is...
One thing, if you're a bar owner, you don't want is a bouncer.
Loses focus.
Just like to say a big shout-out to Vader's Finest and Mandalorian Tactics. Two great podcasts to listen to.
There we go. They'll be calling us up for our insight shortly.
Yeah, they are great. Particularly like Vader's Finest drink section, Cantina section. Talk about some great ales. We talked about my favourite rum the other day.
What would you suggest? That's it. If you were suggesting a drink,
it would be a Mount Gay premium rum.
There we go. They've already done it. We've got Tribute on tap in the bar here.
We do.
I've had a pint.
Which is okay.
It was good.
It's okay.
Cornish.
It's an ale.
Goes well with cheese.
Liking the brew dogs at the moment, though.
Can't go wrong with a brew dog. So Matt can really just enjoy this. 28 minutes to bask in the fact he can relax.
To recover, take more of his prescription drugs, which he should or should not be on. We don't know. We do not know.
The players have been in now for nearly 11 hours.
It's true that. It's longer than I ever stay at home, Tim.
Yep. It's the longest I've been in one place since NAM.
Since prison.
Prison of the mind.
Free the Curhoun too. I remember the campaign.
Got sucked into that by Rob.
Everyone gets
Robbie Angle.
Rob.
Oh, that's not
Rob
his
Angel,
words.
Blindsiding you since 1982.
Hey. Where's he gone?
Nobody knows where Rob Angel is
the
gone.
The judge is gone. Gone local.
Game being closely watched by... national tournament organiser James Fox.
It's run a great event. Did we say the largest in the world?
Chief keyboard operator Chris Oakley and Rob West from Firestorm Games.
He's just walked in. Oh no, he's fallen down the stairs.
No, only joking, Rob. We'd certainly like to get up and play some games at your place soon, mate. I haven't seen your new hall and we'd look forward to doing that. So.
They want to send their best boys down to Exeter for one of our tournaments, let them do it.
A lot of friends of ours out there from the Halls and War Machine days, Mike Jenkins, to name but one. No, to be fair. Very good venue, we do need to make a trip there. Very big in X-Wing, I think. Got a lot of X-Wing up there.
They have the regional. Back to the game, Craig. Who's going to win it? I want a name.
I guess from a streaming point of view, looking at what's happening, we need to make some improvements so we can see a bit more.
Okay.
I don't know how we have to work on that.
We can ask the players to put their face in front of the camera and see if they're happy or sad.
I think I'd say Rob's happy.
The scores reflect it. You don't look that happy, no?
No, I'm not.
Happy in 26 minutes' time, Rob, yeah?
Well, if I've won,
yeah.
If I've lost,
yeah. But then again, you were up by about the same at this point in your game.
Oh, these games, we all know they swing massively, don't they? They really can.
Here's Rob Angel. Rob, a word from our sponsors.
Honorary tournament organiser today, Rob Angel.
How did the snack bar go, Admiral Akbar? We had It's a Wrap.
I needed them out and
what, what else do we have? Death Star Cakes. X ring rolls, they were good. Ham solo roll, they were good.
Chewy cheese straws. Boffin brownies.
Boffin brownies, yeah.
Sorry?
Is this health remaining? Quite good. Calamari rings.
I'll do 1, 2, 3 and a weekend.
So that's 1 on a weekend?
Yeah.
Okay. 1 on a weekend?
So let's look at this really. If the Bamford goes down, it's going to give up 10 points.
Closes the gap, 17.
So give up 9, so yeah, it does close at 17.
6 points. You're still looking for a 6 point swing. You've got objectives, right?
There are 2 objectives still on the table, yeah. It's
not impossible, is it? Not lost.
No, but
I would say... Alistair's got the skill.
I would say Rob's in a favourable position on those objectives right now.
Meaning health on the...
I'm back in Alistair, I'm telling you.
Okay.
Right. Mr. Weekend.
I'm somebody in the other way at the moment. Focus.
Bring the volume down. Alistair did say, like, a Toronto Maple Leafs. Has trouble get past the semi-final. That's what he implied earlier. Psychological, he said. He needs a faith healer. At my suggestion, not him.
Tim Bland there with more noise.
Worked for Glenn Hoddle. Worked for Glenn Hoddle.
It did work for Glenn.
Until he lost his job for saying that stuff about the disabled. Rightly so. He said he got sacked. Not rightly so. Rightly so he got sacked.
Yeah, Tim Bland low in the tone since 1982.
No longer weak. Anything but a one. No longer weak, no longer focused.
Troopers are falling back.
Nah, she's just dropped a...
Getting
a
battered back.
Just dropped a Tuscan with a trooper there.
So Blaze, what's Blaze got up? Its sleeve. Her sleeve? His sleeve?
Well, you would think that, because if you look at the pose, it looks like he's trying to shake something from his sleeve, doesn't it?
Right, wave my hand.
Blaze's wizard sleeve.
And relax.
I mean, you almost might think he's calling the band for something.
Get out of my bar. Here's the judge, Rob. Any judging challenges today?
I prefer to think of Rob as the silent judge.
Yeah, he's always judging. Here comes the long shot. Here comes this. He's going to try and shoot, is he? He's going to shoot. Long shot to the Banfer.
It's a six square.
Banfer's taken 17.
Banfer's got 17 damage on it, so this could do it. It's a long, long shot there.
That's a hit.
That's a hit, both.
Good shot. I mean, I wouldn't know. I can see a green and a blue square in a box.
Cover 7, is it?
So 3 damage.
So he does 3 of the 4 necessary to kill. So it's live by 1. Skin of his teeth. And we all know a 1 health bouncer is a fully operational bouncer.
Here comes the second one. He's called it. Is it going to die, Craig? Yes or no?
It's a lot of range there.
It's a hit. It's dead. It's gone.
Then it's gone.
1 health bouncer. It's fully operational until it isn't. Closes the gap.
6 points in it now.
I told you, I'm back in Alistair.
6 points in it now, so.
No, that's the Rob, but I just think he's going to push it.
Ooh, to be fair, this is a big swing. This is a big swing.
And he's lost that offensive power, so should we look at the south of the board? The moisture farm is open. We've got Gideon, we've got C3PO, we've got Tuscan. Can you ask players to point at the objectives, please? Thank you.
Okay, yeah,
cool, cheers, thanks. Sorry to interrupt.
Okay, so there you go. So that changes things. It's not a token down where we've
walked. Yeah, okay. A little over 20 minutes remaining.
All you, because I'm all out.
As the first.
Raiders.
Do you have
initiative passing back to Alistair?
No. I have none.
If he gets that kill, turns to me. Point ahead.
I have one starter round effect. It is reinforcements.
There comes reinforcements. You got
reinforcements.
It. Back in the.
Eventually.
The elite stormtroopers. He hasn't yet, no.
This is public information, actually.
Yeah.
So you can use data theft to look into my discard pile. So yeah, one reinforcement to come out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards.
Really, that's one reinforcement out of 6 cards.
Yeah, one reinforcement left.
Yep. He's got 21 minutes.
Is it my initiative, sir?
Do we see the pass happening enough to get pull the card? How do you win the game then, Craig, from this position, free for player?
Okay. Deny it. Who are you going to block to get it?
Is Rob going to have
to... Kill the Tuscan and run away.
Playing for time?
Kill the Tuscan.
It's pretty too objective.
Canny
yeah.
for that,
yeah,
it's too
yeah.
canny for that.
So both players have a part of the puzzle they need to win the game.
Need to get more points than your opponent.
Objectives won't do it now, I would say. I don't think they're going to be United.
I don't think objectives were in play the minute they owned one each anyway at this late stage with models at the table. It's really going to come down to...
What's this model?
Killing models.
What's this?
What's that model there?
Yeah.
Is that a HK?
It's still an HK.
It's a focused HK. And
there are
two
focused
HKs. Gideon as well.
Or focused Tusken.
That 3PO by the objective, by the terminal. So yeah, we've got 3PO by the terminal in the cantina. Next model down, which you're looking at on the screen, is Gideon with a focus, and the next one down, the darkest looking of all the models, is a HK with a focus. Tusken's just backed out of the cantina.
I'll go Agent Blaze.
Mm-hmm. Here comes Blaze.
One, 2, 3, 4.
Shaking that sleeve.
Let's go with
trying to stay away from mirrors, who doesn't realise how ugly he is.
So the pass back over to Rob.
Yes, Rob's activating Gideon.
Mm-hmm.
He's focusing the Tusken
focus. Looking forward to Ben Kenobi, Craig, that's the question.
Massively,
yep.
Massively, Tim. Scum player through and through, really, but yeah. Yeah, I could see a use for him in there.
Tusken Raiders and Ben Kenobi, yeah, it's natural fit in the fluff, isn't it?
I think, well. Yeah. They're kind of in the same place at the same time.
I'm looking forward to getting my hands on the Greedo.
We need some Jawas, mate, don't we?
Oh.
Fancy flight, we need some Jawas, please.
Get us Jawas.
Definitely Jawas, yeah. And then Ewoks in hang gliders.
No, they really must be. I mean, no, valued customers. So what is on your fancy flight wish list? That's what we want to know. In the chat room or on Craig's imagination.
Jawas, Tim.
Jawas, you want Jawas?
Easy to paint.
A Land Crawler?
No. Fool.
I mean a map.
Of course not.
Not an actual Land Crawler, a map. Set on a Land Crawler.
Yeah, I suppose it would be quite good actually, Tim, yeah.
Yeah, I see. Right, that's my idea, and if it comes out, I'm
like
suing.
What I'd like to see is some moving terrain. It's almost a break in the map that slides backwards and forwards.
You mean like in episode 2 with
the
rolling factory?
Exactly,
yeah.
Yeah, I really would. I'd like to see
of course,
a piece
of terrain that after that.
You move, say you move 2 squares, for example.
We first see our Nexi.
Yeah, so a word from finalist today, Matt Watson. He'd like to see see a Rancor. I think we all agree with you on that one, Matt.
Come on, he's in the final. Give him a bloody Rancor.
Gundars as well. Sorry, mate. There's a lot of noise from Mr. Bland there.
I want a Naboo Starfighter and X-Wing. So here come the troopers.
Struggle to get a shot. It's very tight. Yeah, very good game, actually. Struggle to get a shot here.
Tighter than Rob's trousers.
A lot of position for the Imperial player, I'd say. He's going for a shot. I tell you what, I am impressed by how far away he's shooting with these troopers. It's not something I 3 to 4, maybe 5 I was comfortable shooting with when I had my brief foray with Imperial.
Currently missing. I'll need to see your.
You were never on the Vader's finest, then.
No, you never
got on that bandwagon.
I run elite stormtroopers and love them. Elite pro droids, one of my favourite things. Imperials, Royal Guard, and Royal Guard champion. But I was back in the day, really.
That was back.
So ready?
Yeah. Royal Guard champion doesn't cut it anymore.
We're on the reset then. Here comes Initiative.
I have no end of round events.
Okay, so we are hearing some good things from some of the guys here. That
I struggle against the Royal champion, so I beat him in the end.
Start to me. I have no start.
Coming up to 15 minutes, 16 minutes on the clock.
National tournament organiser James Fox here at the moment. James, can we have a word? Have you spoke to Fantasy Flight about possibly streaming at the event? So we are
by professionals. Are
we going to commentate as well? I'd love to do it, yeah. I'd be involved. Yeah.
You'll be the guy taking the tickets on the door, Craig.
Yeah, if you'd like to hear more from myself and possibly Tim.
Well, I've got to say 2 things. Number one, facebook.com/curtaingames, KIRTONGAMES. We're working on a jingle.
Yeah.
Follow us there. Free balloons and mugs for the kids. Have we gone mad? Checking the chat room.
There's no one talking in it,
but I was checking it.
Alistair's just dropped the HK.
So he's up to 25. There's that swing. We predicted it would happen. And even if we didn't, we're going to say we did now. This is going down to the wire. Make a call, Craig. Who's it going to be, Alistair or Rob?
It's Alistair's game.
He's changed. He's hopped off the fence and he's gone into that. To be contrary, like all good commentary teams, I'm saying Rob's going to do it.
I've changed my position three times in any match we commentate on. but when I've made my mind up at the third time, that'll be it.
So let's have a look then. Here come the Tuscans.
Yeah, third time is a charm.
We were commenting on how he had the bar, but now the troopers are in there. The Tuscans are falling back. 3PO's there. Could be an easy points nab.
Someone should just shoot 3PO because he's a nuisance, isn't he?
My favourite earlier was when my Nexu ate 3PO. Hi, Chris. Hang on, no, my next he didn't eat 3PO. In my head he did. Because that's what I wanted to happen.
Yeah. I'll tell you something, like Tim today I've been impressed with. Played against Mac. Rebel, little rebel dude.
Oh, yeah.
Two blue dice on attack. Fantastic command card. Play that, cost three. You can only have one. You play it, your opponent can't use any command cards for the rest of that turn.
That's so not bad, is it?
My HK list only uses 12 points of command cards. I'll drop 3PO at 2 points. I need to find another point, but I'd like to get Mac in there. It's fantastic. I have considered dropping two regular HKs and go to one elite.
Have you got to have 3PO?
Have you got to have 3PO? No, not really. I mean, 3PO probably gives me a couple of focus a game. If I'm lucky, I can get him to a terminal, but he's very slow, so he doesn't give a huge amount of this. The surge block can be handy. But I'm not sure if it's necessary. Mac was...
Here come the Tuscans then.
So obviously moving on to take advantage of the cleave that the Tuscans have inbuilt in them.
Has he got enough units to put the pressure on enough to show those troopers back?
I don't think he does, man. The problem now, the troopers are so robust, we know there's another reinforcements card in those next six cards.
Next four cards, now you pull two in the last start.
Okay, yeah, so he's
got two block.
I think what he's doing is just spread the net nice and wide now.
Five damage, two surges, though. We could be seeing something else.
Yeah, but I think the troopers can take a loss. They can take a loss of the guy there.
Could be. Three.
Well, it's a strong place. Not going to have initiative next time, so it's got to. Okay.
Judging there from Rob. He's the best. He's the best in the business. And we're the best, yeah. In the world of Imperial Assault streamers, we are probably two of the best from the pool of...
Two of the only.
Well, me and Adam earlier, and now me and Mr. Reed. He hasn't said anything controversial in a minute. Thank you, Rob. A word from Admiral Akbar Snack Bars just re-upped us.
Yeah.
Oh, a bit of a groan there from Rob Walker. It could be curtained soon.
He's played well.
10 minutes he has. All these players that made the semi-finals deserved it. Those who fell away in the quarters, not so much.
Hey.
Ba 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 bum.
Woo! It is true. I say no regrets, mate. Good quarter-final game.
So next year, we're sat here next year. How do you see Imperial Assault expanding?
It's in a fantastic place right now.
Next year, yeah, quite right, 6 months, because it's.
We've got the imminent release of the Inquisitor. That would actually, Matt Watson making a very good point there. Yeah, some more characters from Rebels. Obviously, we've got the Inquisitor coming there from Star Wars Rebels. It's. There's it. I mean, Zeb would be amazing, wouldn't he? Kind of a Bivvy style character, I think he'd probably be. I'd like to see how they can make him a bit different.
Triple block.
Yeah, it could be. Yeah, it could be like a weaker Skywalker, probably around the 7 cost or something like that. That could be good. Yeah.
Skywalker,
yeah,
with,
yeah,
a lightsaber, yeah, and a robotic hand.
Yeah.
Robo hand.
We got, obviously we got the Force Awakens that we're going to see some stuff from as well, haven't we? We'll have Rey at some point.
Rey and okay, BB-8.
Oh, BB-8 would be fantastic. I don't
hopefully
know.
Hopefully, become the new 3PO. No, but I just want it to be the tax that everyone takes because it's BB-8. Also, I've got a Lego one I'd like to use.
I could see maybe.
Some points change. 27-23, Alistair moves ahead.
Not Poe Dameron, what's Rey's mate coordinate? Yeah, I could see Finn maybe taking damage as he's within a certain amount of squares of someone or something like that, or moving to intercept and you have to attack him or something like that. I could see something like that being very good.
It'd be interesting to see some synergy between two characters.
Well, that's I think with the. Yeah. Yeah.
So, like.
Yeah. So we've got like Mern Rinch, it's kind of, well, it, Snail Man, kind of.
9 minutes, guys.
Ezra Bridger would be fantastic, yeah, because it would give him a ranged attack and a lightsaber attack. Yeah.
Give him a time announcement, Rob.
Yeah, so yeah, he could have just a ranged attack that just stuns.
Hmm? What happened in under 10?
I mean, I'm interested in exploring the stun meta a little more.
Okay.
Just to hold people up and slow them down.
Will we see a different army from you?
Yeah, Chris. Anyway,
different army from you next year, Chris.
Yeah, I could see some new harmful conditions. It would actually. The thing is, it might make Dengar more relevant as well. The fact that you can change one harmful to another. So, yeah, any new conditions could innately make Dengar stronger. Yeah, agree with that.
So, Tusken's falling back. Troopers are pushing. What would you change in your list? Are we going to see a different list for the next round?
For me?
Yep, for you.
So my list is 2 Elite Exu, 2 regular HK, regular hired guns, 3PO Gideon, Temporary Alliance, Devious Scheme, and Beast Tamer.
You change it?
I'm looking.
Has
at
it let you down?
Dropping a unit of HKs, which give me 8 points. Taking 3PO out and putting Mac in, that then takes 2 points out, puts 3 in, leaves me with 7 to spend after a unit HK's drop. And I'm actually looking at putting Dengar in to get that harmful condition. I can convert to stun to slow people up, to hit them with 2 HK. Still gives me 4 ranged attacks over 3 activations, not 2. So that's the changes I'm looking at making moving forward.
Just slow them down.
Yeah, and the fact, yeah, when I get it to a 7-point swap out, yeah, like you said, there's a lot I can do. Yeah, Elite Tuskens, good thing with Elite Tuskens, well, from my point of view in that list, they hold terminal so much, but they play the midfield, which I don't have. Yeah, and then I'll batter you. Yeah, it's true. So I'm just going to give the guys a call. Should we, Tim?
Yep.
7 minutes.
7 minutes, chaps. And it's very close, 4 points in it. But where's he get this 4? So do we? So where's he pick the 4 points up for?
Initiative at this late stage, I would say. It's
The reinforcement cards come up, and the stormtroopers back in.
Yeah, then those units are too robust.
They ain't losing. They ain't losing them, are they?
You're not going to score the points off them now. Rob played fantastically, some really nice play with the band for that. This guy will shoot at
the Tusken. It all looks like it was going so easy, didn't it?
It didn't do my layman terms what I think some people do and just ram it down the throat at someone. He really did play it well, kept it involved with all the rest of his models.
In the end, it was that long shooting. We didn't expect it, but it was effective.
Yeah, surprise. Okay, so score change. Yeah, I think it's the Tusken down now. So
23.
Alistair's just popped the Tusken. Yeah.
Give me a wipe.
So Gideon will wipe the table. Wipe the table.
When he's gone, that's it, isn't it? No explosive explosive armaments. Do you not rate them?
I tried them on HKs.
GG.
Oh, well done, guys.
Alistair Scott has taken it.
Alistair Scott.
Congratulations, Alistair.
Rob Walker.
Unfortunate. Commiserations to Rob Walker.
The score doesn't really reflect how tight that game was.
I think it was a great game.
Up until the later stages. Great to watch, so thank you both.
So the final will be Alistair Scott versus Matt Watson. Stormtroopers versus Scum and the Bosk Boys.
A Trandoshan list with some shoe.
There we go, yeah, we know
saboteurs.
It works. You want to make any comments to camera chaps? Now's the time.
So this will be good. This will be interesting.
For me, the entire game was
so we'll let these guys talk for a minute now.
I started with it. I was able to sacrifice a big Bantha Swamp just to put enough pain on the HKs. Took out one HK, took out the other two before they had shot. That's, 50-60% of your offensive capability, and it was still close.
Yeah.
You did. That, I think people say attack the Bantha immediately, and they're right. But if I see HKs that are hanging out, the stormtroopers can get through that 5 damage, so they'll go for it.
Oh. Yeah.
We're out. Let me just put them on.
Thanks, guys. That's great. So stay with us. We'll be back for the final.
20 minutes.
If that.